Okay, welcome to the first participation project. It's called Excel Basics. We're working on the housing problem, as you can see here. I have the instructions opened up in a separate web browser. I recommend that you either download them or open them up as I have here. And hopefully you have downloaded and extracted the files that we're going to be working with today. A couple of CSV files, an XML file, and an Access database file. So the first thing to do is to open up Excel. So I'm going to go over here into the start area, and I'm going to go down to find Excel. We're working with Office 365, and we're just going to create a new workbook. And we're going to go all the way down here, and we're going to name it housing. Access will put on this .xlsx, so don't worry about that. So we're going to save this as housing. So I just went to my desktop and I put it there because it's going to be easy to find. And I just put in the name housing as it's specified in the directions, and I'm saving it. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make some adjustments and additions to these sheets. So we're going to rename this first sheet homes. So to do that, we're going to go back to Excel, and we're going to go where it says sheet one right here in this tab. We're going to right click. We're going to select rename, and we're going to say homes for right there, and I'm hitting enter. To add a new sheet, you click this plus sign right to the right of it, and we're going to rename that second sheet to home values. So I'm just going to copy and paste this from the instructions. And using the same steps I did to change the home sheet, I'm just going to right click or do Control V and paste. So that is the home value sheet. We've got a couple more that we need to do. So we need a total value sheet. I'm just going to type this in because it'll be about the same speed. So I'm going to add a new sheet, and I'm going to rename this one to total values. And the fourth sheet we need is projections. So projections is what we're going to call it. And analysis questions is the fifth book. Analysis questions. The next step we're going to do is start importing some of these files into Excel. So for 4A, we're going to start with the homes.xml file, and we're going to import that starting in cell A3 of the home sheet. So we're going to go over here to the home sheet. And starting in cell A3, so whenever you see in the instructions these bolded letter and number combinations, those are the cells, and it starts with the column, which is a letter or combination of letters, if you go out that far, and a number. And anyway, so we're going to click on cell A3, and we're going to go up top here. This area is called the ribbon. And in the data tab, you'll find over here in the get and transform data section, this get data. And we're going to click on that button. We're going to get it from file, from XML. And it automatically took me to where my files were that I extracted for this particular assignment. However, for you, it may go to the downloads or the documents folder. Mine is on the desktop. I like to put all of the files I'm going to be working with for any given day there because it's easier to find everything. So I'm just going to click on this homes.xml file. And I'm going to click import. Now, you see nothing right here. We need to select this homes data right here. And I'm just going to hover over the right boundary of this pop-up so I can expand it. And I just make sure that all the data looks good. Now, I'm going to click on this drop-down arrow right beside the load button. And I'm going to click load to. The table part is fine. We're going to do it on an existing worksheet, and that's the one that we're currently working on. And it's going to start it in cell A3 just like we want. So make sure that this radio button is filled in. And we're going to click OK. And that grabs all the information that we're interested in. So we're done with this import. Okay, the next one we're going to import is going to be the homevalues.csv. So there's a couple more steps to importing this type of file. So we're going to go into the homevalues worksheet, and we're going to import them starting on cell A3 as well. So we're going to click on cell A3, which again is the column and then the row. We're going to go up here to the data tab under the ribbon. And you can either click this from text slash CSV or in the get data, if you're not seeing this button right here, from file, there will be from text CSV. And it should take you to wherever you started grabbing those data points from. It's really crucial that you make sure that you're not going into the zip folder, that you're just grabbing it from the extracted folder that you had all this stuff from, or you're just grabbing the extracted file itself. We're going to click on this first one, which is the home values. We're going to import that. All right. We're going to make sure that this is based on the entire data set by clicking this drop-down in the pop-up that showed up here so that we get all of the data. And then we're going to also edit this import because we don't want the header for the data that we're importing to have column 1, 2, 3, so on and so forth. This row right here, this first row, is a header row. So we're going to click edit. And it's going to open up this Power Query right here. And what we're going to do is we're going to use the first row as headers. And then we're going to click right here where it says Close and Load To. We're going to click Close and Load To. Existing worksheet. And it's going to be in cell A3 of the worksheet that we were on before. And it's going to import it as a table. And that's exactly what we're looking for. All right, the next step is to import the total values CSV. So we're going to go to the total value sheet, starting in cell A3. And again, going to the data tab in the ribbon. I'm going to click on this button right here because it does the same thing as going from get data, from file, from text. So I'm going to get total values. Import. Again, we want it to be based on the entire data set, so we're not missing anything. And all of these nulls will just be empty when we import them. So we're going to edit this again because the first column, or the first row rather, is all these column 1 through 10s, and that's not what we want. We want to use the first row as headers. And we're going to close and load to. Since that's it. And we're going to do this to the existing worksheet so that it goes in cell A3 of the total value sheet that we made. and just scroll through it, make sure that you have everything that you were looking for. And that's good for the total values. All right. For our next step, we're going to be importing projections, which for some reason I don't have on here. So I'm going to make a new sheet and I'm going to call it projections. And I'm going to import it into cell A5. And this is going to be from an Access database. So I'm going to go appear into the Data tab again, get data. And this is going to be from database, from Microsoft Access database. And it's going to be this projections.accdb. We're going to import that. And we're going to get the forecast data. And it looks like this is all the information that we're going to have. The first row has the headers that we were looking for. So we're going to load this to our existing worksheet starting in cell A5. And we're going to click OK. And that's how you import an Access table. Okay, for the next step, we're going to enter some information into the home sheet. So starting in cell A1 of the home sheet, we're going to enter homes in each state. So just click on cell A1 and start typing homes in each state. If you make a mistake, if you try and use the arrow keys, it'll just shift around. What you'll have to do is you'll go up here into what is known as the formula bar. This is where you'd, or the function bar. This is where you'd also enter in functions for a particular cell if, when we get to those. Now, this is also where you'll go to edit things much easier. For the next one, we're going to do in cell C3, 1970. So we're just going to delete the homes part right up top there. And we're going to do that for the next several pieces of data for these headers. So we're going to just delete the homes portion right there. And that takes us through part 5. So for step 6, we're going to get the home values by state. So we're going to type that in under the home values sheet on in the cell A1. So that's home values by state. And I'm just going to hit enter. And for step 7, we're going to type in cell A1 total value of homes by state. So I'm going to go to the total value sheet and in cell A1, total value of homes by state. And as you can see, there's some overflow. Total value of homes by state, so that's correct. For step 8, we're going to go to the projection sheet. And we're going to type in cell A1 forecasts in A3 scenario. So in cell A1, it's going to be forecasts. And then in cell A3, that'll be scenario. And in cell A4, we're going to have 2010-2020 homes change rate with a colon afterwards. So that is 2010-2020 homes change rate with a colon. And then in B4, we're going to have 10.7%. So I'm going to click on another cell like C3. And then when I click on cell B4, even though there's text that's overflowing into that, it'll allow me to type in that cell. And as you can see, it hides the overflow from cell A4, 10.7%. And that concludes step. In step 9, we're going to go to the analysis question sheet. And in cell A1, we're going to enter question number. And in cell B1, immediately to the right, we're going to type in response. And then you can just hit tab, and it'll take you over to the cell immediately to the right of the cell that you were just working on. And we're going to put in response. And I just hit enter. And the last thing we're going to do for step 10 is we're going to copy the projection sheet as a new sheet named forecasts. So we're going to right-click on the projection sheet. We're going to move or copy. We're going to create a copy, and it's going to be before projections. We're going to click OK. Now you see it's called projections 2. We're going to rename that one by right-clicking on it, and we're going to rename it forecasts. Hit enter. And as you can see, the information contained within these sheets is identical when I go from one to the other. I'm going to right-click over projections, and I'm going to delete this one. It's going to ask you if you want to continue, and you're going to click delete. So now you're going to go to file, and you're going to click the save button, and you're going to save this and submit it.